It's so messy.
Don't.
Ein Glied nur um der Kleine, die zu fahren, die Jörgen getrieben hat, mit Zimmer, die Weidjurz. Mit Zinnig oder mit den Knichern, die Jacke, die Körner. Die Jacke gibt noch der Patrone, die Knie. Auch mit Zinnig gebrannt, die Zinnig. Auch mit Jürt nichts. Auch mit Jürt noch mit Nordkirchen. Okay, prima. This near part gets a department to the right side. There's any one needs to. That's the treatment to. What we just need, what's in these days? What we just need with needs? That's genetic fact. What might get a right in the right side? If it's sad,
Before this big wall, before that was up, we've had them bring down the INS bus, 60 people at a time in my pasture, 60 people wandering around. And they themselves were only illegal, just the standard illegal. They weren't up to no good. They wanted to get over here for a better job, which doesn't exist. They're just told that. That's a myth. But that's what they're here for. They don't mean us any harm. You know, I'm not scared of them, you know, like that. But 60 people, they leave a lot of garbage. They have to change their clothes. They have to get out of the clothes that they came over the border with. They've got more clothes with them. Well, this is disgusting, and it's the truth. It's the truth, and it's a fact, and I don't know how people watching this will take it. I don't know if you will want to edit this out. It's because they smell. It's their smell. A group of them can walk by, can walk right through here. And if I come through here in 10, 5, 10, maybe even 15 minutes, I can still smell them, the lingering odor. They have to change that. You'll see an awful lot of perfumes. Axe is real popular. Axe body sprays, deodorants and things like that, an awful lot. So then you have the Mexican national, they smell one way. Other than Mexicans, particularly Middle Easterns, because of their diet, smell just as bad, just as strong, but they're different. So you can pick up on, there are other than Mexicans, they call them OTMs, and then or MEs, Middle Easterns. You have Mexican nationals, you have OTMs, and then you have MEs. And you can sure pick up on that smell. Like I say, it's kind of disgusting, but it is what it is. You know what we smell like to them? A hamburger. A lot of people in other countries will say Americans smell like hamburgers.
Thank you. Sublation, which I had to look up, which is called a partial dislocation. So I think what he's referring to was the line being dislocated from the ego line being dislocated from the creative line. So the music in his composition forces you to listen with both minds. That makes sense to you, what he's saying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very glad he's here.
He's here. Very touched.
I really appreciate you more. I just want you to know that I admire you a lot. It's very difficult to know what to say.
Well, he's working with you. I mean, he wants you to know that when we talked, he has made it clear to me that he came to your dreams and that he is working with you ongoing. I mean, this is not something that's going to end. I feel this is going to be an ongoing thing. This is an honor to him. He feels like you really truly understand him. I'm hearing you understand him. You understand the mind of the artist and the two diameters of the dimensions, even this music, the forcing of listening on many numerous levels. You see what I mean? The background is important as what's in the forefront. In the art, the forefront and the background are juxtaposed. I don't know his work, as you know, and he's talking about this juxtaposition. Did you write this first phrase in here?
Yeah.
He loves this. This is him right here. Did you? This right here. It's political poetry?
Yeah.
Yes, you love that. I love that. This original view?
It's a quote.
Of you?
No.
It's original. He loves this. He loves this childhood. Yeah. Loves that. But I think, as we discussed, he's going to continue to work with you. Just is. Now, and it's on these levels, what I think I'm getting most strongly tonight is the different levels of awareness. Okay? The awareness of what's in the background noise, and the what is in the forefront. And that you're hearing both simultaneously. And that neither one push is giving one message, but the subliminal is in the back. So there's a lot of subliminating in this music. You see, this to him is very appealing. The sublime, not the sublime, but what is also right in front of your face. It's very interesting. There's such a juxtaposition. This is why I'm hearing. It's what I was hearing all the time. Subluxation. How do you look forward? I love what you look forward to. Subluxation is disjointment. It's actually a physical condition, but this is a disjointing of the two dimensions of the mind. That's what you do.
Yeah.
Now this I feel is who he was in his work, and what he says to me, this is who he and what he represented in his work. I haven't seen all his work, but in my mind's eye I've seen it and I've spoken to him, and there are many levels and layers there, and this I think is the most important thing he's trying to stress tonight, what he heard and what he's so proud of here that he did tonight. To many, 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 many minds, many levels.
I'm just very happy that did a piece last day, a piece together, and I would like him to talk about that piece. I'm very happy with it, and I need his permission about this piece. Can I say that this piece is by him?
Now this was something you just came through. Came through you. Yes. And it was one of these pieces?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. It was one of these last pieces?
Is this one actually?
This one here? We just heard or this here?
This one.
Yes. Yeah. Well, this is symbolic.
Yeah.
This is symbolic for the breath.
Yeah, he mentioned it.
The breath in concert is a play on words. Like those plays on words. So the breath in concert is your breath in concert in harmony. Breath in concert actually means breath in harmony. It's a play on words again. So he likes that. So this is breathing in harmony, breath in harmony. So that's his breath and your breath in harmony. This is not temporary, this is permanent. This is a permanent relationship. This is what I was told. You're going to continue to work with him.
pray you will not hear that.
So I hope what you're saying is making sense, because that's what I'm hearing.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense.
Okay. Now, the artist's mind is saying he could not function if he didn't have the artist's mind. Mind, the artist is really what surpasses time. There are a few things that surpass time. Art surpasses time. Music surpasses time. Things that are continued to remember throughout history prior to music. He could not function, I mean, here as it didn't in any capacity. He did much else until he really found that. And that was, but he had the brain. His brain was really, when as he comes through, able to function on numerous levels. And I feel he did that in the piece. Correct?
Yeah.
So there was the practical, but there was also the background, the practical and the back. There's always a juxtaposition there with him. Does that make sense? Is that it? That's what I hear from him.
Yeah, well, I always think about him in most of my work. I think he's present in my life in that sense. So, a lot of my work here is very interesting. I'm so shocked, and I can say so.
Yes, you can. Totally. This is ongoing.
I'm very happy.
And this is symbolic. The breath, combining the breath is symbolic of combining the breath of the past with the breath of the present and the future to be.
Do you think that the child thinks that I can say that this piece is a collaborative piece between me and him?
Yes. Without hesitation, I can say yes.
That's great.
And again, symbolic of the combining of your energy, because I feel that you have a contract with him. What you're at least around karmic contracts, so I feel there's a contract with him. To work with him. This is why you came up with this. This is breath and harmony. This is combining of the breathing. Now the breathing, in another tradition, you can look at it as this. This is art. The breath is symbolic of the life force. So law of art comes from the universal life force. So this is symbolic for combining life forces. There is no really, he's energetically alive. It's just that he's not physically present. So his work exists through the breath. The will exists through your breath, through your work, through this, what you are going to be doing. This is all now. I mean, this really makes perfect sense in your mind.
I'm very glad he's here. I just want you to know that I appreciate his work a lot, and it has changed my way to see art. I don't see art as a profession, even as a philosophy. It's just the only way to live as a human being.
The common. It's a mindset. It's a certain, when you create, you go into that other mind. He both finds a present, which is very fascinating to me. To him. But I also believe that that's how he worked. That's how he worked also. That's the way his mind worked, is the way that it's represented here in the music. You can hear it. If you listen really closely, you can hear it. Because there is this, and then there's this. But they're both going on at the same time. Neither one is more important than the other, but they're both there. They're different representations. It forces the mind to expand, really, that music. Forces the mind to expand. It's all about expanding. In many ways, he likes the expansion, he wants to expand.
Yeah, well, his work is beyond the art.
It's beyond the art, it's into the universal consciousness. Really. That is in the background. There's more pragmatic stuff in the front. So it's a juxtaposition, but it is both at the same time, but that is how the mind works, really. Once you tap into that other dimension, because that's where the creativity comes from. That comes from the universal mind. That's there in the back. The ego mind is in the front. You have to have the ego mind, but you want the ego mind to be subservient to the artistic mind. Great left winger.
Is he still the champ here?
Mm-hmm.
Can I ask him something? What would you say to these people here about anything?
Great thoughts come out of nowhere. They don't, you can't create a great thought. And then great thought comes out of nowhere. Great thought comes out of the silence of the void. So everybody here that's creative, I think there's a lot of creative people here, of course. They need to listen to that other voice that comes in when the mind does the same, is not doing that. So you have to, if you want to create something that is original, it has to come from that source. That's where it all comes from. And to learn how to tap into that, you have to quiet the ego mind. So I think the message is art lasts, music lasts, writing lasts, very other few things lasts. And to be a creative person is to be different, is to be not in the realm of the normal. It is to be, to step outside the boundaries of what people believe to be possible.
Thank you very much for being here, Michelle.
You're welcome, Sissy. It's such a welcome.
Town. This is another project that me and my friend Tomek do. This is a Polish recipe for lemon vodka. And we think that it's a piece of art, because if art works in that way, in the way that makes you see the world different, so this is a piece of art.